Hello everyone, welcome to Topper IAS. So as part of our daily series, today also we will discuss a main topic, okay? So the issue that we have picked up is with respect to human trafficking. See, trafficking recently in news because see, COVID has resulted in increasing cases of trafficking in the country. So different childs have been made, you know, become orphan, and that has, and even poverty has caused, you know, increase in trafficking. So let's see what is with respect to trafficking in certain details, okay? And there is also a bill which has been brought out by Indian government. So coming to human trafficking, see, basically human trafficking is nothing but trade of humans for the purpose of forced labor, sexual slavery, or commercial sexual exploitation of the trafficker or the others. So buying and selling of, you know, commodities takes place. Here human beings are sold as a commodity. So this is immoral. It is not acceptable for the moral reasoning of a mankind, okay? So we call you ourselves a civilized society, right? So civilized society should follow a civility. There has to be moral values, but you are selling a human being like a commodity, which is unacceptable. So human trafficking is a thing which occurs within a country as well as across the countries. So we call it as transnational. Then human trafficking is the third largest crime industry in the world. So this is behind drug dealing and arms trafficking. So basic things related to human trafficking. So human trafficking is crime in itself, but it is also a propeller of several other crimes. Meaning is, so selling and buying of humans is basically in itself is not acceptable because people cannot be treated as a commodities. So this itself is wrong, but human trafficking, apart from this, it also causes n number of other things which are unacceptable. For example, parallel black economy, which fuels child labor. So child people are employed, children are forced to work. So that will lead to black economy. Then child marriages. So because of human trafficking, so poverty and all this stuff, people are selling their children. So in the name of child marriage, prostitution is also, which will be risen because of this. Then bonded labor, they are forced to work, forced beggary, then people are forced to beg on the streets, drug related crimes, so children are used as a means to sell drugs and all those stuff. You have a corruption issue, and you also terrorism and other illicit businesses. So this you know, trafficked people will be used as a means to achieve these all kind of n number of illicit works. So these are also which are will be resulting from the trafficking. Then certain things which you have to know which are related to trafficking in India. So that is not everything with respect to constitutional and legislative provisions. So trafficking in human beings or the persons is prohibited under the Constitution of India. So it is Article 23. Remember that. So we have Immoral Trafficking Prevention Act of 1956. Which deals with the prevention of trafficking for commercial sexual exploitation. And we also have Criminal Law Amendment Act 2013, okay, which has a section 370 of the IPC, and it has code has been substituted with section 370A IPC, which provides for comprehensive measure to counter the menace of human trafficking, including trafficking of children or exploitation of any form, including physical exploitation or any form of sexual exploitation, slavery, servitude, or forced removal of organs. So these are also dealing with the trafficking, okay? Criminal Law Amendment Act of 2013 is also addressing the trafficking issue. Remember that. Then we have POCSO Act of 2012, that is Protection of Children from Sexual Offences Act 2012, which has came to force in 2012, is also a special law to protect the children from sexual abuse and exploitation. Because we have seen one of the other things which happens when the persons are trafficked is sexual exploitation. So address such issues, particularly with respect to children, POCSO Act is there. Then how to address the issue? See, if you want to address the issue, trafficking is because of n number of reasons, particularly socio-economic causes of the crime. See, people are poor, they are unaware, you know, because of poverty they think that selling a daughter will give them money. So even the girl will be a burden to get married and, you know, look after her expenses for education and all this stuff. So poverty is one such reason which leads to human trafficking, and not only that, lack of awareness, lack of education. So these people get become under the trap of deceivers. Those people will exploit the lack of awareness of the people, and also will exploit the innocent, vulnerable children who are in the adolescent age. So those all causes are there. So you need to create awareness, so then only you can address the issue. Okay, then punishment to traffickers. So obviously better implementation of the law, and you see that traffickers do not get away with the crime. Then protection and rehabilitation of survivors. So it is not just about punishing the traffickers. You see, the people who have been victimized, now once they come out, it is very difficult for them to even live in the society. So you should take care that you rehabilitate them, rehabilitate these survivors in a better way, with certain living shelter, providing them shelter and certain support for the livelihood. So these things will be done, only then it is like a completely addressing the issue. If you just punish the traffickers without rehabilitating the survivors, it is like a half kind of work, half-hearted work, you can say. Okay, so those kind of issues need to be addressed. So as I said, the bill is there. Once it becomes an act, we will see in detail what are all the provisions which are there in the trafficking bill that has been introduced by the government of India. So in today's class, what we did is, what is trafficking we understood in constitution, where the trafficking is mentioned, and how shall we address the issue of trafficking. Okay, that's it for today. You can also download the PDF of this document in the link that is shared below, and do download Topper IAS Institute app, so that you get access to n number of videos which will help you in your UPSC preparation. Okay, so that's it. Thank you.